morning, so today's gonna be about the warp stabilizer filter on Premiere. I'm annoyed with stabilization lately. I can't afford a gimbal, so I need to find a way to have a stabilized image when I'm walking and talking like vloggers do. So I'm gonna do a few test shots, and then we're gonna roll through pretty much every setting that can actually be done with the warp stabilizer filter on Premiere. Okay, let's do that. To have a general view of the result of each settings onto the warp stabilizer, I thought it would be good to put it everything into a grid so we can see what's going on. So I explain how I went through it. The numbering is actually the way I went through it. And if we start with number one and look at the result, drop down by default is on smooth motion. Number two, I changed it to no motion, then realized on number three that smooth motion was the best, so went back to smooth motion and started to play with the smoothness. So we've got 15% and then 85% on number four. And then I started to play with the method. So we've got number four, one method, number five, another method, number six, and then number seven. And then from number eight, I started to change the framing, the borders framing up to number 10. So just quickly, number 10 is extremely processor demanding. All right, that's it. And now I'm gonna play everything together so you can rewind and watch the differences and realize what's actually best for you. In this test shot, sorry, I'm just holding with my right hand, not moving. Here we go. And this test shot, I'm walking backward. And on this test shot, I'm walking forward. The microphone is wobbling a bit, so that might contribute to the vibration. Here, I'm just walking normally as I'm usually doing. Here we go.